since 2000. Yet we still say, oh, our number one export earner. In fact, cocoa is the most important crop in this country. But just for a purpose of education, it is not a number one export earner. That's just a fact. I'm sorry. So mining has dominated in terms of export values, merchandise export values for the country. And then the contribution to domestic taxes. I think there's been significant improvement. And if I took the figure that was given by Mr. Ayi last year, the money sector contributed 16% of government domestic revenue, which is probably the number one contributor. So now, what are the challenges? What challenges do we face in terms of our current regulatory systems? And I identified a few of them. One is multiple regulations and interinstitutional conflict and inertia. The mining sector is probably one of the most regulated sectors in this country because of the nature of it, just the nature of it. You have the Minerals Commission regulating it. You have the Water Commission regulating it. You have the EPA regulating it. You have Bank of Ghana regulating it. You have Forestry Commission, depending upon the situation, regulating it, and all that. So about six or seven institutions actually regulate that. So again, when that happens, for business purposes, it becomes very complex. then the inertia, nothing is moving. And on top of that, there is conflict. Sometimes this institution says, you didn't tell me this, so I'm not going to look at it. I'll come and take it away. I mean, we knew, I'm sure Mr. Kakari would remember that the EPA and the Minerals Commission have had to struggle over who manages or who regulates tailings dam. And this was a real issue for the industry because when the Minerals Commission would say, we are in charge, so we regulate it. And then the EPA would say, we are in charge, we regulate it. And it's not only Ghana that has happened. In I think, British Columbia, I read that they also had a challenge of that nature, regulatory conflict. So it's really an issue.